Hey guys, so this week I kind of wanted to talk to you a little bit about a question that I've been getting a lot lately. So as you guys know, I weightlift because I really like the way it makes me feel, and I also kind of like the way that you can change your body just by exercise and by weightlifting. And so I've gotten a lot of questions about how I've made such awesome like booty gains or just like gains in general in terms of muscle. And I thought I would make a video about it because for me, as you guys know, I've been training for a little over 2 years, but I've only actually been making significant gains, I'd say, in the past like 8 to 9 months. And so a lot of that had to do with my nutrition. So way back, I'll say like November of 2016, probably a little before that, like September 2016, I had been weightlifting for about a year. I was going hard in my workouts. I was training really hard. I was sore. I was killing it, but I wasn't making much progress. So it's like my weight would stay stuck. I was stuck at like 140, 141 pounds for I'd say a good like 5 to 6 months, and like my weight would fluctuate. It would always stay around the 140, and it was frustrating because I was training, I was lifting like 3 to 4 times a week, I was doing intense cardio, I tried alternating with like HIIT and just regular cardio, and I wasn't seeing like any change. And so I thought it must have to do with my diet, like I must be eating too many calories. So at the time I was consuming around 1200 calories a day, and the way I calculated this was because up until, for I'd say like the past 3 years, since like 2011, 2012, I'd always been eating 1200 calories. Like in my mind, for some reason, if I went above that, I would gain weight, I'd get fat. Like I remember once at the gym, a trainer told me, he was like, you should be eating around 1500 calories. And I looked at him like he was crazy and he had like 3 heads. I was like, are you nuts? I'm gonna be like the size of a house if I eat that much. That's insane. And so in my mind, I was like, okay, I'm eating 1200 calories. If I wanna lose weight, I have to cut that. And so I would cut like 200 calories. And mind you, at that time, I had no idea about macros. I was just literally going off of calories. So what I did is I just slashed my calories until I hit like around 1,000 or 1,100 calories a day. And I was still working out and it still wasn't taking me anywhere. Like my weight wouldn't change. I was stuck at 140 and I was so, so frustrated. So I'd say about a year and a half ago, I discovered macros. And so the way I calculated my macros, I was like, oh, I don't need to hire someone to do this. I could do this myself. So I went online, I went to a bunch of like macro calculators. You put in your age, you put in your weight, your height, and all that. And then they ask you, do you want to gain weight, lose weight? And obviously I wanted to lose weight. So I put lose weight and it calculated my macros for me. And it would give me like really, really high protein. I think I had like 150 grams of protein, which I mean, it's not insanely high, but it's like relatively high for someone my weight and my height. And it gave me really, really low carbs, I think like 80 grams of carbs or something, and low fat. And so I tried doing that, and I mean that obviously, like I did lose a little bit of weight on that, but it was difficult to maintain, like eating high protein, low carb for more than 2 months. I was like, I was losing my shit. And so what would end up happening is that I would start binging. And so like I'd be good for like 3 to 4 days, and then just one night I would just get this urge and I would down like 6 Kit Kats, a pint of Ben and Jerry, and like some potatoes. Like I'm not even kidding with you guys. I would down like 3,000 calories within like 1 hour or 1.5 hours of sitting. And then I just like feel bad about myself. And then the next day I'd go work out. And like this whole cycle would be where it's like, I'd be good for 3 days, I'd binge. I'd be good for 3 days, I'd binge. And then my weight didn't change and nothing really changed. So as you can probably assume, my body was not too happy with this binging cycle, and it wasn't too happy with this like restrictive dieting cycle either, because like I said, I went off the online calculators, like the online macro calculators, which can be accurate if you know how to like tweak them. But if you just go straight up on what they're saying, it's not very accurate. Like they don't take into account how much muscle you have. They don't take into account, like they'll ask you, do you work out or do you not? But they don't take into account whether your cardio is HIIT, if it's fasted, how many times a week you do cardio, how many times you strength train, BMI, and so on. So there's a lot of factors that they don't take into account, which is why they were problematic for me. Like, they didn't work for me. And I don't think they work for a lot of people because, again, this is an algorithm. It doesn't take into account who you are and your type of body. And so basically at this point, I was still eating like around 1200 calories, even with the macro calculator. And I don't know if you know this, but I'm 5'1". I'm pretty active. And so like my body eating 1,200 calories a day for a span of like 3 to 5 years, it was not loving it. It was just like, all right, she's starving me, like, forget this. If she's starving me, then I'm just gonna hold on to fat for dear life because I'm never gonna get any nutrients, and like, I have to wait till the next binge when she just like downs a ton of carbs and fat and that's not even protein. My body was just like, I'm not losing weight, I'm holding on to this. So that's basically what happened. I was eating lower calories, but my body wasn't responding because it was afraid. It was in like a starvation mode, and it just held on to every single bit of fat that it had for dear life. And so what I needed to do was to basically tell my body, it's okay, I'm not starving you, we can, here's more food, we can lose this weight now. So what I ended up doing, I followed the person who is now my trainer. I used to follow her on Instagram, and that's how I found out about her, my trainer Lacey. And so I contacted her. I was like, hey, I know you're a trainer. She's now a registered dietitian. She's phenomenal. She knows her shit. And so I contacted her and I was like, hey, I'm stuck at 140 pounds. I'm eating 1,200 calories a day. Like, this is kind of my breakdown of my macros. Like, I'm not losing weight. What the heck is going on? And her response was like, girl, you gotta eat more. And when she first said that, like, in my mind, I freaked out. I was like, what? No, this is wrong. I can't eat more because I'm already fat. And like, in my head, I was fat. I wasn't totally fat. Like, my BMI was pretty decent. But in my head, I was like, oh my God, I'm fat. I'm gonna eat more. I'm gonna gain weight. I was like losing it. But I was like, you know what? I'm going to trust her because clearly she has a degree in something I don't. She's a registered dietitian. I have a neuroscience degree. Like, as much as I would like to think I can handle this, I cannot. So I was like, I will just trust what she said. And so she upped my protein was taken down to like 130 grams. And then my carbs were upped from 80 grams to 140 grams, I think. And my fat was like pretty much the same, like 30 grams or something like that. And at first, I'm not gonna lie, it was freaking hard eating that much carbs. Like, I've never had like an eating disorder per se. Like, I was never anorexic or bulimic or anything like that. But like, my mindset of eating more than 1,200 calories and eating carbs with every meal was like terrifying to me. I can't even tell you. So it's like, I'd be eating a cup of rice and I'd just be like, oh my God, this is too much. But then after a week or so, I started like getting used to it. And I also started noticing that I'm losing weight. I know this sounds crazy. I went from 1,200 calories to 1,500 calories. I upped my carbs. I kept working out the same. Like, I didn't increase my cardio or modify my training at all. But as I upped my calories, like, for the first week, I think I lost like maybe half a pound, which wasn't like that significant. I was like, oh, this is water weight. But then the following 2 or 3 weeks, I started noticing that I'm like losing a pound a week. I'm losing like a little over a pound a week. And I was just like, oh my God, this is crazy. And so, along with losing weight, which made me really, really happy, I also noticed that after about 2 to 3 months, my body started changing the way I wanted it to. So the way I noticed this is obviously progress pictures, but I also used to measure like my glutes, and used to measure my quads, and I noticed that like they slightly grew. Granted, it's like a quarter of an inch, but even still, that's a quarter of an inch more than I had made in the past 2 years. And so I was like, I ended up starting to do like some research on this because, you know, I was like, I'm eating more, but I'm losing weight. And then I'm also gaining muscle, losing weight, but still gaining muscle and making the gains I want. And so I started doing research, and I know you guys have heard this a million times, but in order to grow your muscles, you need to eat. You need to eat a lot. You need to be in a caloric surplus. And so I was in a caloric surplus to the point where it's like my muscles could get the nutrients that they needed. But I was also losing weight because I was doing like cardio and I was still training. And so that was basically my secret. Eat more to lose weight. Now, I'm not just saying up your calories to 1500 by downing 2 pints of Ben and Jerry's, because that's not going to do anything. You're going to give your body carbs and fats, which it might need, but it also needs protein, and it needs it to be broken down in a specific ratio that works for your body. And so I'm still working with Lacey, and we still have to tweak it like every month or so, because as my weight changes, as my body changes and adapts, you have to like change your workouts. You have to add more cardio, take away cardio. You have to change your macros. And also, another thing that I noticed is that you have to listen to your body. Like, sometimes my body, like, for example, this month I have retained so much water weight. because of these allergies. I've had the worst allergies. Like, I've had rashes all over. My body was losing its shit. It looked like I went dancing in a bush of poison ivy. It was, like, crazy. The doctor was like, what the fuck have you done? But I swear I didn't. And my body was just, like, losing it. And so I started taking antihistamines, and those caused water retention. And, like, instantly, within, like, 2 weeks, I'm back up to 140. And I was like, this makes no sense. I haven't touched my macros. I haven't changed my workouts. And then, as, like, a registered dietitian, Lacey told me, she's like, don't worry. Antihistamines cause water retention. Once your body kind of gets used to it, you'll notice that, like, the water goes away. And surely enough, this week, all of a sudden, I lost 3 pounds. It's not that I lost 3 pounds of fat. I've lost the water that my body was holding on to. And so that's another thing you guys have to keep in mind, is that don't just focus on what the scale says. Take progress pictures and focus on how you feel. Because your body weight can fluctuate 5 pounds every single day just based on water, sodium, the amount of carbs. Carbs retain, like, they hold water. And so if you eat a lot of carbs, and the next day you'll probably weigh more because you're, like, holding on to more water within you. If you haven't gone to the restroom that day or whatever, like, 5 pounds is how much your body weight can fluctuate. And so I don't always focus on the scale. Like, yeah, I use that as a good way to kind of check out what's going on, but I also look at the way I feel. I look at progress photos, and I think those play the biggest role. So that's definitely something that I would recommend. And of course, if you see that you're stuck and, like, your weight's not moving and you're not really sure what's going on, even though you're killing it at the gym, I would suggest contacting a trainer. Contact someone that knows about nutrition and can calculate your macros for you, and not just someone that's gonna go onto an online calculator and plug in the numbers. Someone that actually knows what they're doing. Registered dietitians, they're excellent. They're definitely worth the price tag that they're charging you because they know what they're talking about. So that was basically my answer to the question of everybody asking me how I've been making these gains and how I've grown muscle mass and how I've lost weight. I hired someone to calculate my macros for me, and someone that knows what they're doing, and they helped me eat more, eat better, lose the weight, and make the gains. So I hope that answered you guys' question. Please feel free to comment below with any questions that you have, or comment on my Instagram. I always respond there. And as always, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to comment below and obviously subscribe to my channel. Thank you guys. I'll see you next week.